I just wanted to say that.
All right, I'm going to call the meeting to order.
Okay.
Thank you all for being here. Thank you for your time. And for the wisdom that you have to add to our discussion today. If you would please take a minute to review the agenda, I would like to add one thing under new business, and that is CIP. CIP stands for Capital Improvement Projects.
Under 11?
7A CIP. Is there anything else people would like to add to the agenda? I move the approval with the addition of a discussion on the CIP. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Dennis. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you. Review and approve the minutes. Thank you very much, Kathy, for providing the minutes to us. This was also another difficult meeting, and you did a good job. I think that part of the conversation around activities is not in here. Dennis, did you want to add something?
Well, I thought it was kind of important that we did discuss the fact that when an activity is held over at that community center, there is a dollar per person, a fee, and I thought that it was kind of important that that should be entered in there since we did discuss it.
I thought the conversation that we had after the meeting was informative as well, and that Karen said that township facilities like the community center and like the senior center can be reserved, and we could use them for activities as long as we don't say this is a bad township function. So, like for instance, I could rent the senior center, and I could invite people to come over, and we could play Uber. And as long as we didn't say it was a township event, then we could do that. Again, I think it's the dollar a head per person.
Is that a dollar a head per person, or is that a rental fee?
In lieu of having it be the rental fee, I would expect, I mean, if you're going to use the senior center for an hour or two, I would not expect you to pay hundreds of dollars to rent it. So in lieu of that, I would ask for the dollar per person.
Okay. I just thought that that should be clear because that was part of the conversation after we closed the meeting. Mm-hmm. And it was for clarification as we continued the discussion. But I think it's important that we realize that these facilities are our facilities and available to us.
Available.
And we want to use them to do things in it for, you know, seniors or whoever we can. Any other discussion about the minutes? I move the approval of the minutes. Is there a second? With the change of adding the $1 per person fee when we're using the senior center or the community center. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you, Kathy. Again, the treasurer's report. We still have our $32,000, I assume, balance.
Uh-huh.
And how's the flower fund?
It is still intact. Not as last time, but I do have some gray. In the hospital, I can't remember his last name. Ray and the Lord Dorothy. Anybody remember his last name? Okay. Genevieve called me talking about it, but I haven't been up there yet.
She might be able to. She's got a last name?
Yes.
Okay.
She does. Because she's not here today. Okay. I'll have to wait again until tomorrow.
I'll leave a text to her. I think we'll have her have that for you.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
If you want to mail, I can go out one person and get it.
Sorry, you know it's still intact.
It is. Same amount as last couple months.
I don't really have public with us today. Marie did send me an email to say she's out of training and sorry that she couldn't be here. No other public is in attendance. Old business dashboard. So I left that on there because I think it's important that we continue to talk about the fact that COVID is still among us and that the numbers fluctuate and we still need, I feel, to be pretty much aware of what's going on and
yeah,
where we are.
I agree. So there was an outbreak in the township 2 weeks ago. We're much past that 10-14 day period, thankfully. But we would do the same thing if there were some type of outbreak at the senior center, which thankfully there had not been that we've been aware of. People are they're still encouraged, and if they wish to wear a mask, it's not required at this time. Clinton County is still reporting very low numbers, which is thankful. I have been watching the CDC. The new variants, of course, are always popping up and are more contagious than the one previously. Without having, you know, a mandate for people to get boosters, it sounds like there's a booster that's available for people that are 50 and older, and it sounds like there's going to be a booster in the fall to accommodate the new, some of the new variants. So we'll just continue to make that information available to people. And if we can host a clinic, we will host a clinic. We will ask Clinton County or the Mid-Michigan Health Department if we can host anything. Yeah, because I think that that is, when we did it the one time, it was very successful. And if we can do it like we did last time, kind of as a drive-by, fantastic. Or if people come to the building, fantastic. Right. So, but we will make our resources, our building available to them if we can, hold those clinics.
Very helpful for both.
Yes.
The Mid-Michigan Regional Health Department.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Any questions?
They're in the sneezy corner.
Any questions for Karen about the dashboard and other things? Great. So we are going to move quickly here to PR and outreach. I know we had postponed the June 21st luncheon, and we were today to discuss a September date that perhaps we could check with Mary and see if she would what might be available to give her lead time and notice. So again, it has to be a Tuesday or a Thursday in September. Probably should be, I would assume, after Labor Day. Labor Day is probably the first Monday or something.
It's probably.
So what is that? The second Tuesday?
The second Tuesday is the 13th.
Going to have the day of our meeting?
What was the question now?
Oh,
yes. Didn't have the day of
our meetings are on the second Tuesday.
Oh, great. Right. That would be very good. We could do it instead of a meeting, I guess. But
no, I think we could probably do it. I just
no, you can debrief it, I guess. You could see how it went and talk about it.
After the meeting?
Right after.
Yeah.
And all the leftover food?
Yeah.
Luncheon and have it stop at a certain time, give us cleanup time, and then have a meeting.
That's what we're saying, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. What term did you use?
Debrief. Debrief it. Yeah, I just was thinking you could talk about how many you had attend, you could talk about like what went well, what you could change with, kind of like what Dennis did. It would just, you would have that like immediate follow up of how'd it go.
So that would be our meeting.
We have the luncheon and then have the meeting right after, and we can talk about how the luncheon went and.
And whatever business.
Whatever business we had to do that. Yes.
But can anybody do that?
I can't. I get my son's getting moved that day. I'm going to be here.
Well, then, that's okay. Then. So I was going to say, would you like to pick an alternate day?
Yeah, what's the next Tuesday? It must be the 20th?
The 20th.
Are we available?
If we did the 13th for a meeting, we could make sure all of our ducks were in a row for that.
Prior to the 20th.
Right. Are you available on the 20th?
Mm-hmm.
But you're not available for the meeting.
The 13th.
Right.
Okay.
We have to give you an excused absence, which is fine. Mm-hmm. Jean has an excused absence today.
Okay.
She asked last week to be excused, last month to be excused.
Oh, that's right.
Is not answering
So the 20th. The 20th.
That would be your first pick.
Right.
Okay.
So, Karen, you're going to get with Mary.
With Mary.
Okay. Okay.
And see if she could book that.
Yep.
And then if we have that as a date, we can actually backtrack, you know, to figure out when the notice should go out and how many resource people we should have there and who should make those calls. So
can you remind me you wanted a luncheon?
Mm-hmm.
Or did we go with something that I know we had a couple of talks, but you would prefer a luncheon. Okay.
Typical to one of our luncheons, you know, so they have the idea when they come for lunch how it would be.
Okay.
And then I think that we should have, and this is where Jenna comes in, I think that we should have resource people around the room, like the hearing aid woman who comes to gas for hearing aid, then I think it would be nice to have maybe some of the service providers, maybe someone from Aiding Hearts, or it could be that we would have someone from CACS who might come and talk about weatherization and some of their other services.
How about elder, you know, elder law?
Elder law.
Came recently, yesterday.
Question, are you turning this into something bigger than a luncheon? You're doing a...
I think that...
Seminars and stuff?
No. My idea is that we would just have some resource people around so that they could see the connection.
And they could...
Right, they...
People could go to them and
announce that they're there.
Right. So that they, the people who come, can see that we have connections with services and resources that are in the community. We can even bring them in.
But we're not going to have them speak.
No, they're just going to have
to say that. In fact, so if Dana had questions for CACS, maybe she could go get a card.
Okay.
And find one of them or talk to them quickly.
Just that.
I didn't want to clarify that.
Yeah. If they have some class they want to teach later, fine, we'll set that up. But this is just so we can connect.
So, and then try, maybe try county?
Some of the retirement facilities probably would be interested too.
You mean like Timber Ridge?
Yeah, like Timber Ridge and, you know, like that.
I really like having like the hearing aids and the Aiding Hearts and the CACS and the, like the service. I almost think it feels
services and resources
salesy if you I
love it when Timber Ridge comes in Bowfinger or
yes, but I feel like if they were there then that like some, yeah, they're marketing themselves.
Okay.
Yes.
What about having the kids from school come to help anybody with their homes?
Oh.
Having a tech corner?
Yeah, anybody that they've been out here before for our people. Mm-hmm. And these people are all new and have to give them an idea that these kids come up and would help if they need help with their phone.
And maybe we would have, I know people like it when they serve lunch, when they help people with, like when people can just sit at the table and they bring it to them. Mm-hmm. I know we did that a few times and the seniors really loved it.
So good to
it, yeah. It would be nice to have that as a monthly thing, every month, one day a month.
Would the regular seniors be mad because they're not invited to the luncheon and somebody else is helping them with their phone and they need help?
I think we should try to get the high school kids to come back.
I think so too.
Well, yeah, even
kids have
on
to
on
do
community service.
Community service. And this would be a community service, and they can start from their kind of freshman on through.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm going to write it down in two ways, because I'm going to write it down for that event, but I'm also going to write it down, and it might have been on the list you had for Jenna, but we're going to, I'm going to add it to both places, the tech. And the serving. So maybe we can add the kids.
And if we could have a town corner, they might not have to go to everybody's table, but we can put that in the on the postcard.
Yeah.
It might draw people in because I wish I could figure out how to put an app on my phone, you know. You can help me get that app on my phone. You know what I mean? People might be.
Are you serious?
No.
Oh.
No, I'm just using it.
No. I love that she asked you to read. Are you being serious, Judy?
Great. Anything else on that at the moment? You're going to check with Mary?
So I am. Yep, I'm going to check with Mary for the 20th and Alyssa. And then you want lunch. And then we're going to have Jenna coordinate hearing aids, Aiding Hearts, CACS, Elder Law. Try County, if we agree on that, or okay, and then maybe some tech assistance from the kids.
We don't all of it.
Well, we can see if they're interested. They might not be interested.
Okay, but I would think three or four.
Yeah, maybe she could just contact them and say this is our prospective date. Would you have someone available? And maybe we would come.
We could come up with three or four. I mean, and if they weren't then, we could get them to come
another time. You know, okay. For our regular patrons.
Okay. Yeah. I think it's great.
Yeah, I do. Okay.
All right, good. So services and activities, that's Kim and Nancy and I. Now, Kim, we talked about the resource directory at the last meeting. It was the last meeting. We talked about training opportunities for Jenna with that if she needed it.
Yeah.
and updating how, you know, she finds the right person at CACS who really knows about commodities, and how she adds that to her Excel spreadsheet and keeps that, you know, current. Did we decide if Jenna needs any help?
She hasn't indicated that she needs any help, but I think that we do, if, I do know, Kim, I was thinking that once upon a time, you could merge two versions of a document, and they would, the new information from this one and the new information from this one would, you could almost compare documents, and I wondered if that was still a thing. Maybe we would want to do that, because if she's made changes and you're providing a new, with a new tab.
Well, I'm not gonna touch it anymore. I let her know that.
Okay.
You know. I sent Jenna the updated resource, because I have like 13 new home care vendors. So I sent her the whole thing and said, in case you haven't changed yours, and then, or you can just highlight and then cut and paste into yours.
Okay.
I've changed
okay.
it. Just
you're used to the way that you could.
Yeah, and I know that I know in that email that I don't intend to keep updating that. I think
okay.
it's too confusing to have two people's hands in on something that she's going to be the one making use of.
Okay.
And so she can customize it in the way that she wants to.
Okay.
And then I sent out that contact spreadsheet for all the board members to Taylor, and I sent something else to Jenna.
Activities.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, the activities list for the in-house and outside the senior center. And then I also, this is kind of to do with the outreach. Dana, on the notes from last meeting, did you get with Taylor and talk to her about putting together the flyer?
Not yet, I am not.
Okay, I'm going to follow up on that. And then the other thing is that...
Wait, you're going to follow up? You're going to do it?
No. I just wanted to see if you guys were had an opportunity to get together on it yet.
So she had your changes from, I think, the previous meeting, previous to last meeting. So I think knowing that you wanted to make it more of a flyer and not a letter like she had the format or a postcard, I think we talked about something that they could be folded but not in an envelope.
Correct.
So I say you and her can schedule some time to get back together like you did for bingo.
Right.
And that's fine. That's fine. But she, I think she needs to probably put it in that new format
okay.
so that you could meet and discuss it with it in front of you.
She heard it. I will start by making a report.
Yes.
Set a meeting today.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the other thing about the outreach luncheon was that we talked last month that the cook wasn't available, and that's why we had to reschedule. And so we also talked about Nancy and Dana and I getting food safety certified. And I called Clinton County and Newton County and found out more information about that if they wanted to do it. It's about $125. It was free through Clinton County, but there's only three slots, and we need those three slots available to actual staff, not volunteers. So,
it's Dana, so I was going to say, so you could wait until next year.
Which is or when? What is the calendar?
I don't know what the physical
is. It's
the calendar year. Yeah, it's the calendar year.
Oh, it is?
Our license runs, I think it's April through April, but I think the training runs through the calendar year.
Okay. Well, Clinton County didn't have the openings until October, and Ingham County has them every month, and then I found some resources for online training, too, if we want to do that. So there's some choices there that we'll just get information from us. So,
but she can always, you were correct, she can, you do not have to have somebody on site, but you can designate a person in charge. So, like, if Mary wasn't able to come on the 20th, but Jenna or Alyssa was available, even though Alyssa's she's safety trained, she would be the person in charge. And that's what we do when Mary's gone from the center on a day we're open. That's what she does. She puts Alyssa in charge.
But Alyssa's certified.
She is, but it's still a designation of person in charge.
Oh, the way I talked to Clinton County, they said you don't have to have anyone certified on the premises. They just have to have them available by phone if you had a question.
Well, the way we've always done it in the center, because we haven't always had the assistant hasn't always been food safety certified.
Right.
We inherited Alyssa with that training, so. Go ahead.
Okay. So then the other thing was, we were talking about the Clinton County Assy, if we were going to be cooking in the kitchen, or if it was going to be outside the kitchen, like on the deck. And I said, we might use the grill. And she said, well, if that's the case, you do need to make sure there's SOP in your kitchen.
We have standard operating
procedures. That says we're going to take the meat from the refrigerator to the grill to a warming plate. And she gave me links to find out verbiage if we needed to add that.
We have those.
Okay.
Actually, these two created them several years ago, and then we updated them.
Why aren't we doing?
I don't know if
that's
okay.
Yeah, really. You wrote them.
Okay. Okay. All right. So I was kind of excited about finding all that jam, though. But
if Mary can cook,
mm-hmm.
If she or us are available,
I hope they both are. That's right. My hope.
Do we need volunteers to be food safe certified?
This is back where I was going to make my statement, and I said later, it's not just this. It's something like a Friday night chicken liver and gizzard.
Sure.
Fundraiser. Mm-hmm. That we would have to rely on more folks. And then we may not be able to and do a fundraiser utilizing our kitchen.
What you would have to do, though, because it would not be for the senior center.
Yes, it would be a fundraiser. For the senior center.
But you would have public coming.
Correct.
Then that makes it not for the senior center. Our license is to, our license is to prepare food in the senior center for the senior center. When you start
for the senior
meal program, when you take it outside of that scope, then you're dealing with how you used to have to do when you go down to bath days where you're getting a temporary license, mm-hmm. because it's not the same as Mary cooking lunch in the center for our meal program.
Oh, I did not know that.
When we had Taco Tuesday, did we have to do a special license?
Yes, we did.
So anytime we want to do something special, we need a special license.
Yes, which you guys used to do when you would do, I think, when you would cook food.
Car shows.
Car shows. Yes. Oh, that's what it was.
Car shows.
I was thinking of these.
And the bad days.
Yeah. But what you have the benefit of is that you have the benefit of the kitchen's already a certified kitchen, but you would just not have access to the refrigerator or the freezer.
Oh.
That's part of our board approved policy for the senior center is that if you're an outside, which you are what you are.
Right.
An outside organization, you do not have access to. You have access to all the equipment except for the fridge and the freezer.
Okay.
So you have to find a way to cool.
Yeah.
And keep things cool differently.
Is there how much was the charge for the special license?
I don't remember.
Okay. Did you get one for yesterday?
No, because it was prepared in the senior center for the meal program, and she did transfer it off site, but it was. She still held it under those.
She cooked outside.
So, but I mean, so to me, that's still okay with me. I've done those licenses before.
Yeah.
If it's not something.
And it's not as complicated because you're not cooking in the parking lot, on the street.
So you don't have to have the hand washing all that.
So you have the benefit of already having the established certified.
And I have no problem with that. If it's okay with the board or you or whoever has to say it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't know Mary. I don't know if she's ever had chicken liver and gizzard, but that's the first. That, honestly, yeah. That's the first thing somebody asked me about when we talked about fundraiser money. It was not him.
No, I don't. He loved them.
Yeah,
so I'm pointing.
It was not him. But yeah, so I mean, that's why we were interested in doing that.
Okay.
Not only just for lunch.
Okay.
Because you know, potatoes and ham are awesome.
So we used one of them.
Okay.
We need one for. Prospective staff hire. And then I don't know if like Diane were to become, you know, it depends on who become the dishwasher. That person could also, like Julie used to assist, could also assist. So come the new calendar year, there would be availability. If there were no staff changes.
You can't hear.
I can't guarantee that, but.
So that seems like it's kind of an internal discussion about moving forward. You know, will we have a fundraiser? Is there some?
That was just thrown out.
No, I know, but I mean, and then my next question is, what's the process? Do we go to the township board to ask permission to use the kitchen for a fundraiser? I'm just trying to take it to the next step.
My discretion. It's like an application to use, to, like a rental application. I would waive your fees of rental because obviously you're raising money from the center. And possibly pay for the license because it's a fundraiser. Because ultimately, who's going to benefit is the senior center.
Right.
So, but you have members of the public, so.
So we do have permission to talk about this amongst us group and then go to you and say, hey.
Yes, we can sit down.
Okay, all right. Good, we got that set. But I just wanted you to know, it's not just we want to enter in the kitchen.
No, I understand that.
Okay.
Yeah, I understand that.
Right. That was my comment that I did.
And I think that's a important segue to the events and community engagement section of the agenda because those are events and they are community engagements and they are good for us. Kathy, did you have a question?
No.
Okay.
All right, sorry.
I do not want to ignore you. We talked last time about the big event and I know that Dennis did a report that was shared with some people. I don't have a copy myself, but it was quite
informal. Everybody should have gotten a copy
last couple months ago.
Not right
now. Okay, I'll get a copy, but it's a great format to follow. It provides a lot of detail. And last time we talked about the importance of having a subcommittee charged with that event. And we named the members. We asked if Jenna could be a part of that. And then we named the members, Dennis, Kathy, Jean, and Jenna, to start. But in order for that committee to work, we need a chair. Someone needs to take the responsibility to call that subcommittee together and to move the process forward. Did you want to join that committee, Kim?
Well, I kind of feel like my subcommittee is kind of cease and desist because everything that I had to organize, I gave to Jenna, and she's going to make the decisions going forward. So, yeah, I'd like to be part of this committee. I started making a list, and it looks like there's a lot to do to make it happen.
Right. So I would like to suggest that we either name a temporary chair of that group so that a meeting can be called. So, Dennis, would you be willing to be the temporary chair since you did the report and have kind of the umbrella picture of the whole event? Just so that
I could do that.
Just so the first, just temporarily.
I can do that.
So, I'm asking Dennis to take on that responsibility temporarily to call that group together so we can start the process.
So that group can elect their own chair.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And we had talked about the value that Jenna brings to that group, and do you still agree that when you lost the meeting, Jenna can be involved?
Yes.
Okay. Is there anything that anyone wants to add to that category, that discussion on events and community engagement at this time? I did see that Jenna was selling or marketing a river boat cruise. I think it was sponsored by someone else.
East Lansing, I think, had reached out and told us that they had the extra seats and that we could market it to our people if they were interested.
That is close.
No, she sold any to you?
I don't. Yes, there were people from the senior center that wanted to go, but they had already had to have their money in by now.
It
is.
The next thing is the strategic plan. Oh, good.
So we have two things in the making. We have the luncheon and we have the big thing in the spring. Do we want anything in between there, or do we want to start working on something else?
Well, that's one of the things our subcommittee is going to discuss.
is if we want to put in some more events between now and then.
Oh, I thought your committee.
Was
Kurt, you get us, okay, I see Dennis County.
If we want activities, whether they're at the senior center or outside the senior center, we need to make a suggestion to Jenna and she'll schedule it. The subcommittee that's in the hot spot right now is the impersonator.
Okay.
I don't think we need to do two big events at the same time. We need to figure out.
But I think that they're talking about things.
We're talking moneymakers, so, I mean, like the dinner thing, we kind of fall under our category. If we wanted to have a money-making dinner.
Right, that,
You talked about the lizards?
Yeah.
I think I'm having chicken livered in lizards.
But I think that, you know, I'll just throw this out, but a fall color tour, you know, where, you know, I think there are other things that are between now and the spring that we can talk about, that we can work towards. Is that what you're saying, Kim?
Well, I'm just saying that an activity, an agenda thing, is not an event.
I think if it's meant to be, like, this is a fundraiser. So a color tour would be, you pay for a ticket and you pay for the cost of going. So I think there's a different, I think what I'm hearing Kim say, what I am agreeing with Kim, if this is what she's saying, is there's activities that Jenna creates and that gets, and then there's the bigger ticket items where you're raising money and doing something or fundraising.
And just before the pandemic, we did a survey and all the activities that seniors were interested in, we put together.
That's what she gave to Jenna.
Gave that to Jenna. So she has that list to work from. And that, in my opinion, that's about as much as we can do, unless she would honestly think of something else.
Sure.
Or she comes to us and asks for
I
else.
I told her in the email to let me know if there's anything you are in there. Offers.
I just want, I'm still in contact with, this was a bad month for me, personally.
Sorry.
So, well, unexpected medical emergencies and the person, it was an unexpected death. So it was hard for me to get in touch with this guy, but I finally did. He's working on the Kenny Rogers and Dolly for April. But
here in town?
Yeah, for a fundraiser. For us.
For our fundraiser?
Yes. Okay.
Like he did help us? This would be a place for that.
Yes. Okay. And he's going to find out. He's got a couple people, but he's got to get cost and all that. But he does a lot of Rod Stewart impersonators. But what I was wondering is if we could get together with Parks and Recreation and possibly hold a fundraiser at the park. Maybe like an ice cream social.
Mm-hmm.
I know we can't do hot dogs and burgers, things like that. If that would be something, say, September, that would the township be interested in?
Yes, because that's traditionally things that we do through Parks and Recreation. We have the Schwanz man will come and we basically, what was that face for?
I want homemade ice cream.
Well, I don't know how to make ice cream.
I know.
I can't even cook, so.
I went to a social with the Boy Scouts and we spent one whole with all the Boy Scouts and ice cream makers making ice cream.
Okay, churning ice cream.
Yeah. Hey, so, in the past, what we did is we would pick a common date with the farmer's market. And we would have the Schwanz, the local Schwanz rep would come, and he would have, I'm going to say four ice creams and then some gluten, dairy-free things available. And you could basically go up and say, I want a bomb pop, or I want a drumstick. And you would get that. And then at the end of the day, whatever boxes had been opened, the township would flip the bill. So you basically could go up and get whatever you wanted. So, if we did something like that, we could do it as part of that at the farmer's market, or we could do it at Miss Western Park and the senior center and maybe some other groups to be available and coordinate with that. So yes, that could occur.
But if we did it with Parks and Rec, could we split the cost of an impersonator with them?
Oh, I see what you're saying. And have somebody performing. I missed that part, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Possibly. I mean, the money either comes from the senior center, I mean, the money all comes from the same pool of money. It's all township money.
Okay.
So, yes.
As long as it's for the senior center.
Right.
For the seniors.
Would that be something anybody would be interested in doing?
Well, that's something actually that our committee should discuss first and then bring it back here and talk about it.
Right.
I just wanted to put it out there.
Oh, yeah.
Good idea, yeah. Yeah, we had a concert, Friends of Park Lake had a concert in the park on Friday night.
I love the name.
Dangle Park, so we'll serve about 60 people. I don't think we've ever really had live music like that in the township before. We wanted to see if it would be popular, and, you know, it was really nice, and we were able to, you know, use the pavilion for the stage that they sang on by relocating some of the tables, and it was beautiful. It worked out really nicely.
Did you get rained on?
Hmm?
Did you get rained on? I know you were.
No. Well,
oh, you were ready.
See, that lady had a beautiful voice.
Well, marvelous. She's coming back. We're getting her back. Okay, good discussion. Thank you.
So Kathy, Dennis, the director, Kim, when you guys have that meeting, if you think there's opportunities, I can always send Becca Slocum, who's the recreation coordinator. We always have a follow-up meeting.
Should we try to schedule it when Jenna's on the clock, if she's going to be part of this meeting?
Yeah, I guess the question is really her availability outside of her regular working hours, or does the subcommittee need to meet around her schedule?
I will talk to Taylor. So I also know that Jenna's being married very soon. So
this weekend. Last weekend. No, wait a minute. She picked up her dress on Friday.
So that will factor in there, too. But Taylor would have her availability far better than I would.
Okay, moving on. The next one is just a quick review of the strategic plan. Our goal one is 21 to 23, encourage the development of comprehensive programs to serve Bath Township seniors. The first objective is to have a full-time program director and service manager at the senior center, and that milestone date was July of 2022. And it says the current status is that we have a part-time program. It says director and service coordinator, but so I think we're still working on that goal. I don't think that we've missed that. I think we're still working on it. Objective two is to develop resources through increasing partnerships, expanding collaboration program development, and broadening network based on resources and needs, and I think we're working on that as well. Three is to utilize staff training, which results in program expansion, increased collaboration, and expanded networking, and I think that the work that Kim has done to provide those resources to her provides a good grounding for that. Objective four is to focus on meeting seniors' needs for basic medical equipment and incontinence supplies, food security, and transportation. I think we're doing a really good job with that. We have quite a supply of things that people can use. Dana?
Are we back to being able to order them, or is it just what people are bringing in?
No, when the diaper bank, the Lansing diaper bank closed, Brittany took the township van, and I think in two loads filled that van twice, and it's all in our basement here. So we have supplies from here to St. John's.
Well, before we couldn't get back in to get in.
We couldn't get back in, and they ended up shutting the program. The woman that was doing the program, like when you were dealing with it, is now, she's closed, she shuttered that program. But we have their entire supply in the basement.
I don't, has Jenna, she has another amongst that.
She has.
Okay, I understand.
A list of, yeah, okay. She has people that participate. Okay. She has a pretty good list, actually.
Good.
I mean, we used to have like 17. She's nowhere near that, but she's got a good list of people that are utilizing that service.
And I think what Dana is saying, that she doesn't maybe often enough announce that we have the availability of those supplies.
Well, there was a long time I wasn't going, so I can't say that.
Right.
You know, I really can't say that.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
But we also have people outside of the senior center that take advantage of the program too.
I'm glad.
So I would say that probably right now you have more people from outside of the senior center than you do inside the senior center.
Well, I do know a few people, but I'm sure they're from the senior center.
Okay. Goal number two is to increase the number of participants at the senior center. And I think that we're doing that with our outreach strategy that we've moved now. I had hoped that we could have had that outreach strategy earlier in the year so that as we move towards the next budget phase of the township, we could have said, you know, we have this, we've increased our numbers, there is an increased need that we need to meet. But we haven't had that yet, but we're working on it, and I think that that we're meeting these objectives. I just want to do a touching base and make sure that we're right on track. Continue and expand services to Bath seniors, low-income seniors. I think we're continuing to do that with, if you have a bridge card, I know that Jenna has been made aware of the My Cafe training and the services through My Cafe, so I think that that's going pretty well. Get input from seniors on current and future service needs. Yesterday at the picnic, I went around and talked to different groups of seniors, and they were asking for another survey. Please ask us, you know.
Okay.
They were saying, let us tell you how you're doing, and let us share with you what we want that's happening. And so that's what we said, you know, that we would do, a way that we would reach out and find. And the input was to do surveys. So
is it still the tabletop surveys that you would like to do?
Okay. And then
it's about the survey. Go.
No.
It's a different
She gets the survey.
No, I mean, I'm just, instead of asking for activities, you know, say, what are you missing coming out of the senior center? Make it more specific to them.
Okay.
It's just a suggestion.
No, I think the more personal it is, the more it looks like we're reaching out to them and inviting them to give us their ideas, I think the better. So open-ended questions.
What services do you need?
Yes. What do you need? Or what are you missing? You know, like,
yes, correct.
Yes. And so the goal five is to expand the senior center. Now, Kim helped me with this, and I've tailored it to, but on Friday, the planning commission or planning board is expecting organizations within the township and outside the township with township support to turn in proposals for capital improvements. And I actually went across the street to the old house and dug through all the stuff that I had filed and found quite a few things. But this is the proposal that, these were two copied, right? So these are the 2017 proposal. Because you just take one and pass it on, right? I had Kim copy these for us. We have turned in a proposal for an expanded senior center. As far as I've looked back today, since 2015, this is 17 and 18. And then in 20, we just did a letter, a memo, actually, to the planning board that the 2021 is at the very bottom of your stack. Originally, when we started turning in the request for an expansion, we were talking about a really ornate, fancy building that was going to cost $450,000. And Karen has also done some copying for us.
Well, that was Taylor.
Well, at my request,
yes.
Karen has brought it in. Karen has brought it in. The very last one is 2020. So we have 2020, 2018, and 2017.
That's listed.
2019 and 20. So everyone had a chance.
Okay.
Great. So I just wanted us to see that we have quite a history here. The most detailed of these, and as I said, we started out asking for $450,000. And then we, just pass this around, please.
Yep.
then we started looking at a less expensive way to do it, and now you have a lot to do with this, which at that time, when the last time we turned it in, was about $95,000, if you were at 2020. It was about $95,000. So the application for the CIP is due on Friday. And in order to turn, in order for us, the Senior Services Advisory Board, to turn that in, requesting an expansion, we have to fill out the paperwork. And this is, if you look, as an example, at 2017, or even 2018, the most recent one, you can see that the Planning Board is asking for quite a lot of information, not only about who we are, what we do, and why we think it's important, but the relationship that we have, the Senior Center, to the Township plans and goals, the overall goals and objectives for the township. They have a map. The township has a master plan. And so, I just think that we need to talk a little bit about this. So another thing that I asked Al if he could get for us was the data on the number of meals we've served recently. And Karen put that on the table at the very beginning of the meeting.
Thank you. Did you want this one?
Well, okay.
We'll share.
All right, so this says that in January, on an average, we served 35 meals.
I should note what I've asked here is that there are, I assumed, a number of 20 for to-goes, because Mary has indicated that she serves 50 to 20 to-goes every day. Yeah. So you're serving, the average that's here is the on-site total.
Okay.
And then, in addition, there are another 20 meals that are going out the door.
20 to-goes.
Yes. So the average is only the on-site meals.
Okay. So, if you count the to-goes,
yes,
it would be 55, 62.
Now, you're talking average now, so it won't be specifically that many, but,
You know, we used to see this every month, for the month we used to get the numbers. And they used to be in the Friday report, how many meals we served, and I asked for that to continue, but I haven't continued.
I don't think you had the to-goes in. You know the people in the room over 50.
Yeah.
During that month. I can't add the 20 on top of the other because then people aren't in the room.
They come in and get it and leave.
Yeah.
But the point is,
that's common to meal, but we're talking about the building. If you want to.
Oh, I see.
You've got 85 people.
That can be there.
That can be there. And we're only right now at 42 is the highest.
And in the building.
Three or four people waiting to get the goals.
And I added the days 50 plus. I went through the actual numbers that were served and looked at how many times a month we were getting over 50 people.
On site.
And that would be the.
Getting over 50 people.
Meals and
the feel good meals.
Yeah,
the comfort meals.
Yeah.
Now, the reason I asked Al to get this for us is because Al feels that until we're bursting at the seams and every seat is taken, we shouldn't talk about expanding. And I think that before we get to the point where we're bursting at the seams, we should be planning for expansion. So just to get back to the point, this was a drawing that the last proposal was turned in, was based on this. Now, Nancy, I think when you and I spoke about this yesterday, you have said that you felt that it might be better if instead of on the north side of the building, this was on the side of the building by the communications tower,
and that there be a basement put underneath there where the deck is.
I do believe that, yes, we should put something out here, maybe in addition to, or, I'm not saying that we should necessarily replace that, but I think we should, right around here, have access to a basement.
Or additional storage.
Additional
storage.
And that would pay much to do this on the hill there.
Yeah, you could scan that diner in that way.
How much?
And maybe we didn't have to make the rest of this, I don't know.
How much?
It's just a thought.
About 50.
Almost.
No, you're at 85 right now. If you remove, the staff, which we always take staff out automatically, so you can see 80 currently. So almost, yeah.
Yeah, staff.
Almost half staff. I just say take them out automatically because they're.
And part of the reason for the reduced number of seating that we've added in this particular design, place for a meeting room, which we don't have, like if the VA wanted to come in and do counseling, or if you wanted to do hearing screening in a quiet room, you could do that in, that there would be an office for employees. And then, again, bathrooms, a utility room, actually, I don't see it, but there's supposed to be a small kitchen.
Oh, I think that we added that, like.
Where the coats were, but anyways.
Yeah.
There's supposed to be a small kitchen in here.
Yeah, kitchen.
So that we could actually rent it even when we were using the regular.
So if you were using this, you could also use this.
So you could have funeral rooms and there are family meetings or, you know, people could rent it. So this is what the last proposal that we turned into the planning board was based on. Building an extension that is like this. Now, in the memo that we wrote, it said that last year when we turned it 2 years ago, it was, the construction would be $95,000 and the engineering and architectural fees would be $25,000. So the first thing that I would suggest is that we would turn in a proposal again for the expansion, which would include architectural and engineering costs, and then we would have to find out what this, in this day and age, would cost. When in 2000 it was $95,000, is that $120,000 now? So that we would ask for this in phases. We'd ask first for the architectural and engineering costs, and then based on what it said that the building would cost, that we would ask for the building costs in the following years. And the CIP is supposed to be a five-year plan that they developed, as a five-year plan.
Do any of these years count?
Yeah, wouldn't you hope?
It's only this year moving forward.
Turned it in. But you can see in the year 19, the senior center expansion, again, that was where the cost was 95. This is 19. Then that cost was $95,000, that they would have committed $5,000 in 2020 and $90,000 in 2021. So we're building towards that. You know, that was our goal. In 20, then, again, we turned it in again. The total of $120,000, the $25,000 for the engineering was to come in 2021. And the $95,000 for the construction was supposed to come in 2022. Now, many of you are not familiar with how the CIP process works, but we have turned in all these proposals over all these years. The planning board considers them, and then they score them. And you can see, just looking at 19 and 20, look at 20, so the senior center proposal, there was a total of 70, and they got a total score of 46. And based on the scoring and the priority, the planning board sends recommendations to the township board to fund capital improvement in the following year. And the senior center has never gotten the approval from the township board based on the recommendation from the planning board. So this represents a lot of time, it represents a lot of effort, it represents a lot of work. And I have done this year after year after year after year. There's one year I was looking at, I turned in actually 5 proposals. I was too ambitious. Never mind. But for 5 years, we've come before the planning board. For 5 years, we've gone before the township board. I want to ask right now, I want to make a statement. I personally think that the township administration and the township board know that we want to consider expanding the senior center. Personally, I believe that the township has a fund balance of $4.6 million, as well that they have to spend some down, as well as technical assistance money in the existing budget for 2022, that they wanted to find out what it would cost us today to build a senior center. They could move ahead with leadership from the administration and township board to at least budget that $5,000 or $10,000, whatever it would cost, and do a projection. Today, we know what this would have cost in 20. Today, what would it cost? So I'm asking what approach you might recommend that we take for discussion.
I have a question. At one time, I remember you mentioned something about matching grants.
In this, you can see that we have a verbal commitment from the Capital Region Community Foundation. If we raise half the money, they would be willing, as they funded the kitchen, about 50-50, and not to come in and fund the rest of the project. But until we know the cost, we can't even begin to approach them. We have to know the cost. And so I'm asking you, do you think that we should encourage our leadership from this committee to the township board and the administration to move forward and request a technical assistance, that the engineering and architectural study be done to determine what it will cost to build a senior center? That's what I'm asking. Or should we go through this process again, which they know what we want? They have all the information in front of them. They know what goals and objectives we meet within the township plan. Should we put it all before them again, or should we actually put the onus on them to do the work to say, we have provided this to you for the last 5 years, you know it's a need, you know it's what we want to talk about in the future, move forward and get those engineering and architectural costs, and then next year we can actually turn in the CIP because we have the information. And even if we turn it in Friday, they're not going to fund the building of the building. If anything, they would just give us the money for the architectural and engineering work, which I feel the board and the administration already know we feel is a priority.
My answer would be yes. So you're saying as a win-win, basically, it gets us our first step at figuring out exactly what's going to cost and where our funding is to have this managed grant and going forward. So my question, and I totally agree, but my question is, I look at this, I just have I have some concerns about it, and that I think it's really exciting that there's a possibility of putting in a basement. When I look at this and it's at the north end of the building, and I'm thinking, it's got to be a lot cheaper to add to the north because you're going to keep the roof line. And you're not in the basement. Not even know how the roof line would work if you expanded out towards the deck. So if you don't know for sure which plan you want to go with, can you actually solicit to get a designer involved?
Yeah.
Go forward with and say,
that would be
this is what you're going to have to deal with. This is what's going to be able to do that.
Mm-hmm. To get the technology.
So we don't really have to have all the answers before we go to that. That's what you're saying.
Right. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Karen. I'll let you know what we decide.
I would love that.
Thank you. So what do you think, Gail?
I'm 1 of 7 votes.
I know, but you have a voice.
I have a voice. I think, personally, I think it's this one who we're shooting at the moment when we ask for the size.
This?
Yep.
Shooting for the moon?
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
What's the infant on that?
Why do you say that?
Why would you, what, how do you say that?
Are you saying it's too big?
I think it's way too big. The bathrooms, I'm not sure we need.
If you were using it.
Very expensive. They are very expensive, because you're gonna have to run your sewer outside the building to get down to it. Plus, you're gonna have to run your water from your storage area, or your, in front of the kitchen here, where the furnace room is. Is where the furnace is, and you're gonna, and your water, you're gonna have to get your water down to it.
But those are all things that we would look at when we did the architectural work and the engineering work. We can't say it's impossible or it's too much.
You asked me what I thought.
Yeah, I'm just.
That is what I thought. Now, right. I'm not gonna change my mind just because you're trying to.
Are things like the restroom, is that stuff that could be added later and you get.
They're still very expensive.
You can't.
Why do we need to?
Because you can't have people in here having a banquet walking all the way to the senior center over here to use the restroom. That's why they're necessary. I'm not saying we, you know, but they should be, there should be bathrooms in there. I mean.
Yeah.
Do we need to have a separate banquet room? Can we not just enlarge our dining room?
But they're talking about.
Well, the problem is that
you could run these two lines, which are your, this line here and this line here, the outside of the building, and along the kitchen area. And you could add that area there, which would be, I'd say it's probably 24 by 32. And it would be a lot less money.
Yeah,
you're
right.
What about the grant, though? Don't we need to maximize our use of this matching grant?
How much? They didn't give you $5,000 last time.
The they gave us half of the cost of the project.
And
the project was $110,000. Yeah.
And so they gave us 55. The township gave us 55.
And then it was actually 50, and then we took $5,000 from the senior fundraising budget, the money that the seniors had raised for that last $5,000, because we wanted them to feel like
it was our money that.
I'd like to see more here.
One of the purposes of having two rooms is so you can have potentially have two activities.
Yeah, but we're not listening. We need everybody to listen, especially
this one.
Yeah, I'm saying just add this section here to make it a bigger room.
Right, but you're right.
Your kitchen's here, going to be here.
Why not go out right off that wall?
No, you're
going to go back.
We did a road committee 2 years ago. We tried to do metals and doing our blackout. They have gone up 25% from the county. The county is a cheaper place around for us to do it.
To do what?
To do the metals, blackout. So at that rate, everything else is going up. Mm-hmm. Unbelievable. I would talk to Zeke. He's probably as good a person to ask as anybody. His family's in the building. And he could give you an idea what that would cost without. I know we talked about putting a roof over the deck at one time. And that was going to be $30,000. And that's only 2016 to 24.
Okay.
We're quite a ways from the amount of money that we were going to need.
Great. But we don't know what the amount of money is that we're going to need.
Right. Unless we do. Know until you talk to.
The renderings, the drawings, the architect, the engineer, and get the data.
Yeah. And it's going to run you $20,000-$25,000.
Just for that part.
Yeah.
Right.
Because you have to have, within the township building, you have to have a different drawing than you do in a stamp on it.
Right. So, my question to you was, do you, as our leader on the township board, are you willing to support having the township fund this year architectural, engineering drawings for a future expansion of the senior center?
Yeah.
So would you provide the leadership for them?
Huh?
Would you provide the leadership for them?
Yeah, I can talk to Karen and add what I need to put.
Great.
And, but we're going to have more firm numbers on the amount of money it's going to cost. Because it, you know, it could be $35,000. We have no idea what these architects are charging.
Right.
I have no
idea. Right. But can we find that out and let you know?
Yeah.
Now, how long do architectural drawings last? In other words, if he draws it up, but we don't build for 2 years, are those architectural drawings still going to be good?
Yeah, they're good. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So,
I understand that, and I also look at this, you know, a 12 by 14 meeting room is almost the size of a bedroom. You almost don't need a meeting room. So, and why would you put an office in that building, too? You already have one office area. Why would you mean?
It was thought that maybe the library or somebody would come in with us.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. I'm all for the idea. Don't get me wrong. I just don't like
Frick. Well, and it might have to be this. I mean, this is just an idea that we worked off of.
Okay.
Well, another purpose of the meeting room was, for example, the lady when she's giving ear exams.
Okay.
Yes. It's awful noise for you to give it there. We want her to have a place.
Yeah. Right. And the VA
won't come in. Set up the shots or something like that.
That would be big enough.
Right. And the VA won't come in and do counseling and also give them a private room.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, and so.
I feel better now.
Yeah. So the meeting room is basically a desk and a couple of chairs.
Mm-hmm.
It's not meant to be a conference room.
Just so we can do consultations.
Mm-hmm.
Any other conversations, comments about this? So I am, at this point, going to make a motion that we, as the Senior Services Advisory Board, encourage the township trustees and administration to fund the architectural and engineering work necessary to determine what it would cost for a senior center expansion. Do I have a second? We'll discuss it if I have a second.
I'll second it.
Thank you. Now, discussion.
We've got to give them more than just...
Yeah.
You got to be definite on what you want. Because if you're going to put $20,000, $25,000 into an architect drawing, you've got to have exactly what you want when you hand it to them. You can't... It ain't like taking your furniture and moving around the living room and then saying, well, I don't like it. I'm going to move the damn book back over here. You can't do that. They have to have exactly what you want.
I just think more specific than this.
Yeah. Well, and he has the basement.
Well, yeah, the basement would be over here.
Yeah. But, oh, so it wouldn't be an expansion.
It wouldn't be. You could take the deck off and make an expansion out that way.
So we need to decide what we want before you can go to an architect. If this is what we want, how much is it going to cost us?
But the motion on the floor is to ask the township board and the administration to support.
Correct.
The budgeting use, the resources necessary to do the architectural and engineering work to determine what a senior center expansion would cost.
Okay. So you're going to go in there blind, and they're just going
to say, go in there
into the board and ask for money, or the board. I'm just saying, if you don't know how much it's going to cost for the engineering and the design, then how can you go ask the board for that amount of money?
Well, we'd have to get some. We'd have to and get some budget estimates from architects and engineers,
right.
From an engineering and architectural firm.
And in order to do that, though, you got to know what you want.
Well, I think we have an idea of how many additional square feet we want.
Okay.
I think we have something to start with.
Okay.
Start the conversation with. I think that we can continue to discuss it right here, not today, but at future meetings. And be more informed as we move forward, but I feel my motion is to, for us not to do a CIP proposal. They know all this information. It's in their files. We've told them time and time again. Now it's time for action to ask the board, the administration, to get the to fund the architectural and engineering costs to find out what an expansion would be. I'll call the question. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign.
So are we going to add to this? Because this is kind of what we want, right? You're saying, should we add the basement or not?
Well, I think at the next meeting we could talk about that. What we're going to ask them to
come up with some ideas.
For right. Okay. Right.
All right.
Right. I will just say that since the last time I turned in this proposal, the percentage of people living in Bath Township in 2022 who are seniors has gone from 24.6% to 26.9%. 26.9% of the people who live in Bath Township now are seniors, where 2 years ago it was 24%. When I first turned in, it was 17%. So the senior population continues to grow. Again, not very many people know about us.
Right.
And right, let's do the outreach and let's get the information out there.
That brings me back to a question I wanted to ask about. Can we do some tickets? I saw a lady here this morning. My neighbor's a senior. She doesn't come down here. I want to give her a ticket for a free meal. My neighbors behind us, they don't come down here. They're seniors. I'd like to be able to give them a ticket for a free meal.
I agree. And I think that's part of, isn't that part of your committee's work?
My committee? I don't know.
Well,
she's not.
See, you know, I'll take it back.
Okay. I'll design a ticket.
I agree.
Oh,
absolutely.
Go ahead. What's your mission? But I would think that would be part of our luncheon.
Yes.
If you, once we decide on a date, you can start giving those people tickets for our luncheon in September.
Yeah, let's get tickets. I agree.
She wants to do it now.
I don't care when. I just want to do the outreach.
Right. So let's talk about tickets at the next meeting.
Free
let's
lunches.
Get tickets. Yeah, free luncheon. We'll get tickets. Okay, so.
Well, I mean, we can't do anything. We can do something?
Not necessarily.
I mean, we have to get permission from.
We just, you know, how long are we going to talk about it?
I know, but Karen is going to ask in September. We've got a couple days picked out. If you were here on time, you would have known it. So they're asking for dates.
Okay.
The 20th, September 20th is the date that we're going to get a separate hearing and the Tuesday for that free luncheon. So that's August. Well, it's 8 weeks away.
Yeah, if we wait till next month, we're only 30 days away. Come on.
Well, Dana's working with Taylor.
Okay, so the next thing on the agenda is our BOT.
We're settled on that one. We're okay.
Yep.
Do we want another committee to work on this or not?
Sure. You want to be on the committee?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. You and Dana and I will be on the committee. And Al will be on
the committee. I don't want to be on another committee. I've got enough committees to be on.
But I'm too busy. I'll try it again.
Kim will be on with me.
Okay.
We'll do it at lunch Monday.
Okay.
All right. BOT report.
Nothing except everything is going up at least 15 to 25%.
Oh.
On everything that we after our bids on last year, we sat down the road, it went up 120,000. And so this, unless something happens, the lumber is going to be for this building this year, walking, is going to be about four times higher than it was.
Woo!
2 years ago.
Really?
Plywood was $80 a sheet. Yeah, and it's come down to about 20 now. But this whole thing, it's going to be a lot of money.
Well, that could be a in order to work on it, I need the size of the existing building.
55?
No.
41?
It's 41 wide.
Really?
And it's, well, you figure, you got your, where your freezer is, your storage room, with your kitchen, and the furnace room, your bathrooms, they're all on one side. So you take this off, I believe this was 12 foot. So I guess it's down to about 32 foot.
Well, if I have the wrong measure, I have a 25 foot or a 100 foot.
So Al, is there anything that you want to report from the Board of Trustees?
No, not really.
Meetings, what's going on in the township, what should we know about?
Just, we're going to do metals, one of these $565,000. It's,
he's talking about paving. That's his road, maybe?
Still waiting for the county to, cut the roads, the trees off, Grumheller. And, several of the dead trees on us in the edge of, that was 30,000. And that had gone up 25% from last year.
The township board work here, what about, being able to, attend a meeting via Zoom and have a conversation? Where is that going? How are we doing on broadband,
We're getting a new television up here. I'm working on it, but we haven't got, it hasn't come through with the numbers. And until we have the exact numbers, our supervisor don't want to do it.
Is that, you're talking about Zoom?
Huh?
Are you talking about Zoom communication?
All of that together. Right now, Zoom, the problem with Zoom was we kept getting drunk people calling in and talking to us on the air. And that don't need to go over the air. And unless we can find some way to have somebody listen to it, 15-second delay or whatever, to watch what they're saying, because there was some swearing, and that's not needed in this township.
No, I agree. You know, I want to make you go.
Any questions?
I'll admit that I was sick, and I watched Zoom one day, and you cannot hear. We all know you cannot hear.
Well, because you don't speak into the microphones. They're right there in front of you, and they're out here. They should be right here.
They're talking on right in front of their face, and you can't hear them on when we put them over here.
You can't hear them when you sit in here either, because you don't speak into them, you know. But anyway, it's very difficult. Yeah.
I have a question. From last month's meeting, I have a note that Dana and Doris were going to work with Jenna on bingo training. Did you guys get that? So you feel a lot better that thing?
And I am working with Jenna this Friday about the hot ball and the speed ball that we suggested we add. And then because we were there on Friday, I got a lot of feedback from the people that are playing, and everything that we suggested was right on the money of what they wanted.
Good. That's great.
So, we are good, and I will be there working with her this Friday.
Good. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Dennis?
I also miss mentioning this back in my area, but I would like everybody to read this Elvis thing like Kim did, and I would like next month for everyone to give us suggestions, improvements or things we should change, so when Kathy gets ready to get our other performers, we know what we're doing.
Yeah, I did read that, so the whole thing.
And also to consider what part of it you really volunteer to help out with, because it's going to take a lot of people to help with that.
Right. We were able to get some of the high school volunteers.
Yeah, that was great.
So that helped
a lot.
Homework. Any other comments to come before the board? Thank you for your time. Thank you for your wisdom. Thank you for sharing in the discussion. Greatly appreciate it. Doris, did you have anything you wanted to say?
Yes, I want to resign to personnel. And I don't know when, but I'll be moving out of the township.
What trying to go, get out now.
I'd rather just get out now.
Okay.
It's, alright. Have you spoken to anyone at the senior center who might be interested in your position, or have you, spoken with anyone who was, said to you, oh, it's so great that you're on the committee, I'd like to do that?
Oh, no.
So, I think you actually, have to turn your resignation into Mayor Marie, just to me, so it has to be in writing.
Should be in writing.
Okay. You just bring it to the senior center, Friday, if you want, probably be in there Friday, I'm gonna bring another person in. Thank you for your service. Not only here at the board level, but also in the senior center with Bingo, you know, you're very knowledgeable of your knowledge, and, you know, your willingness to spend time on Bingo and help people, make that a success at the seniors, but that the center has been very important, and we greatly appreciate your contribution. You know, whether it's here in the house, still be, or at the senior center, well, thank you.
She's still eligible to help out on the committees, even if she isn't a board member.
Sure, oh yeah, we love volunteers. Thank you so much. Any other comments? Will we adjourn? Is there a second?
I'll second that.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Meeting adjourned, our next meeting will be in August.
So when will we be on the, Board of Trustees agenda about the grand jury?
I don't know, we're gonna have to add more than just this year to get to the guy.
Oh, so what about the Friday deadline then? How does that work?
For the CIP, we're not turning in the CIP, we're going straight to the board.
Okay.
And I thought you should, but that's.
So you should what?
I thought, I told you yesterday, you didn't, I thought you should.
Should what?
Turn it in.
A CIP?
Yeah, you should not let it go by a year, because then you start over again.
And we just had this discussion at the table, that for 5 years we've gone to the planning board, and they've sent the recommendation forward that the township trustees, the planning board, and the administration know that this is something we need to be planning for in the future, and that you said you would take the leadership at the township board level in moving in forward.
That one vote.
But you provide leadership.
That, everybody up there is their own boss. I don't lead anybody. I will be glad to work on this and to get a blueprint and find out people. The guy we did last time, that did the senior center, his wife died while he was in the process of doing it. And so we took his quarter pot. But it's not, you gotta have, if you're gonna put a kitchenette in there, you gotta draw that in there. You gotta have everything drawn in there. Like Karen was talking.
So do you have a vendor in mind that we should contact to come out and look at?
The guy that we did, no. He was from St. John's.
Okay.
St. John's called in that area.
So I can make some phone calls and try to find an architect that's a commercial architect.
Yeah.
That might just walk us, just come and meet us for a consultation and tell us what they think. Meet with a couple different people.
This isn't just a day's drawing.
Right.
And then you're ready to do it. It's gonna take a lot of talking to people. And I also wanted to say, Karen told me the other day, I told you now, that she will, if you start having your car came over there to the old. I always think it's car came through the lady.
Oh, yeah.
They will move high tables over and some chairs. I think you got enough chairs over there, but the tables will be there. But you have to go and talk to her about getting the key if you want to have your, and the dates that you want to do it, so I don't interfere with somebody else.
Right. Okay. Now, there's also some mention of being able to do it here, so long as it was not,
Karen said that it's
no longer is the law.
Yeah.
No. So long as it's not a township activity.
Correct.
We could do it there.
For a dollar person.
Yeah.
And I don't remember that thing.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they told me, well, you were going this morning.
Oh, okay. I know. I totally forgot about
buying a part for the tractor. Tractor broke down. So, okay, so we can do it here.
Yes, for a dollar.
Okay.
Dollar person.
Okay.
Yeah, in the afternoon.
In the afternoon.
In the afternoon.
Yeah, well, we have to, if there's something else going on there.
Right.
Okay, I think it's very back to schedule, it has or something.
Well, we can go back to.
Thursday, don't you?
Yeah, right now, we're doing it on Thursday, yeah.
And it's not like nobody there on Thursday, so.
Sounds like a good day then.
Yeah.
So we wouldn't have to move stuff, we could just.
And it's on there and you can use everything that's.
And that specifically, you use someone, this person is in charge, has nothing to do with township, any complaints?
Yes.
Or comments on the sheet, whoever.
We can try.
Yeah.
Now, is that going to interfere with your movement for free?
Well, that was going to be on Mondays.
Okay, well, then it won't. Or two, yeah, okay.
You could still have more than one activity in there at one time.
Yep.
We could.
We used to.
Yeah, we, yeah, but see Nancy's talking about Thursday, the senior center's not even open on Thursday, so that would be okay with her.
As long as she's out of there before something might come up later on.
I don't remember.
They have a few things over there.
In the evening, they have tubs and they have alcohols and.
Those are on the same day, I think it's Tuesday.
I don't tell you that we quit the other day, we were done by 4:00.
Yeah.
Yeah, they come in the evening.
Yeah.
If you can get an architect.
I can get an architect, I do, we get three architects. I mean, I just need to start with.
She doesn't.
I just need to.
You don't have to have one. You don't have two pictures, you don't have.
You don't want.
All you have is one.
Couldn't you get?
Later on.
She was talking about getting three quotes.
Oh, you want to get quotes?
I gotta get with some people, I know they're married, I think I can. Because I'm on that subcommittee, right, so I can just learn without.
Yeah. You have permission.
The asking doesn't last very long. Oh, we're off record, right?
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the day's still around.
Oh, is it? Oh, but.
But.